Before we get into it, I want to apologize to you guys. I know it's been a few weeks since I posted a new video, but my job, we're working 12-hour shifts every day. We in high production. It's the summer. So I'm going to try to post more frequently. But yeah, I had to talk about Comic-Con. So yeah. I know. It's been a while since I made a video about the DC Extended Universe. And a lot has happened since the somewhat troubled release of Batman v Superman, which, by the way, the director's cut? Not bad. Back to it, the movie was supposed to kick off DC's cinematic universe and bring some real competition to Marvel Studios' Phase 3 movies. Since the release of Dawn of Justice, due to terrible critic reception and mixed fan reception, Warner looks like they've restructured their entire approach to their superhero franchise. This is very noticeable in the trailers for their upcoming Suicide Squad, Wonder Woman, and Justice League films. So in this video, I wanted to lightly touch on the possible new direction and what it could mean overall. So welcome to the Justice League, and let's get to it. Wow. So San Diego Comic-Con is in full swing and Warner Brothers came out guns blazing with the DCEU. Now initially I wanted to make a part 2 to the What Needs to Be Fixed video, but this time I was going to incorporate Batman v Superman Extended Cut and talk about some of the behind the scenes stuff happening with these movies, but scratch that. Let's just talk about these trailers and what it looks like is going to be an all new direction for the DC movieverse. All of the trailers seem to address the criticism made for Man of Steel and Batman v Superman. And I'll touch on some of these things. It's not an in-depth editorial like some of my other videos. It's just a light reaction. So starting with Suicide Squad, Warner has been rolling full steam ahead with this movie since Comic-Con of last year. The final trailer just really brings it all home. I don't know if any of the reshoot stuff made the trailers, but it's being made clear that this is meant to be the summer blockbuster of the DC Extended Universe. And since we're talking about the Suicide Squad, we have to talk about the Joker. I watched the Joker trailer last night and I really love what I'm seeing with Jared Leto's Joker. I'm all in, and I just want to say, I hope the Jason Todd theory is wrong. This needs to be the only Joker of this universe. And seeing these last couple of trailers has me charged up, and I cannot wait to August 5th. As far as the changes you can really see, the feel of the movie is more fun, more exciting. It's really in the vein of Guardians of the Galaxy. Like, it just really oozes that from the visual look of the trailers to just everything. The jokes, everything is hitting on point. And here's the hoping it all comes together, because the DC universe really needs this movie to hit a home run. With Wonder Woman, I watched this trailer after I got off work. It was like 2 in the morning. And the first thing that really stood out to me, I thought to myself, wow, this is really colorful. Which is a clear contrast from the first time they showed it. If you can remember that teaser that they did on the CW special, the colors aren't all drowned out in this trailer. Her armor really jumps out at you. The reds are really red, and I was happy to see that. As far as the trailer itself, I thought it was interesting. It really reminds me of the first Captain America film as far as the look and the feel. I know some people felt like it was just a bunch of scenes of her fighting guys, I guess, like normal people. I think that they are going to go big. I think it's going to be some spectacle, but they're keeping it close to the chest. If you remember, one of the biggest digs at Batman v Superman is that they gave it all away in the trailers. So we'll just have to wait and see what happens. But after seeing this trailer, I really feel good about this one. I mean, if you can remember my review to Batman v Superman, I spoke highly of Gal Gadot, so that continues with this. And last but not least, the Justice League. Wow. I mean, wow. Okay, first, the trailer lets it be known that the original vision of the DC universe died with Batman v Superman. It's gone. This movie is bright And the trailer gets right into the humor, which was sorely needed in Batman v Superman. Next, I just want to say that Ezra Miller's Barry Allen looks amazing, very quippy like in the comics, and I think The Flash is going to serve as the movie's comedic balance, much like Tom Holland's Spider-Man did in Civil War. Visually, I thought everything looked good for it to be this early in production, and we still don't know if it may come together, like if everything is going to be a good movie, because you know, these things are put together to build up hype. That doesn't mean the movie's going to be good, but I think this is a great starting point. I think they needed this to kind of revitalize the DCEU, and I'm impressed. All three trailers. So basically what's happening here, to kind of mirror what's been going on in the video game industry as of late, what we're seeing is the Xbox One S version of the DC Extended Universe. Warner is kind of moving things around, much like Microsoft has been doing with the Xbox brand as of late. Basically, in 2013, Warner launched their original vision of the DCEU, which was much like Microsoft's original vision of the Xbox One, and the fans didn't like it and spoke with their wallets, and Microsoft was forced to rebrand and repackage the Xbox in order to get consumer confidence back. Warner is pretty much doing the same thing. They thought they knew what was best. They said our universe is going to be very dark and very serious, and the first couple of movies came out and underperformed commercially, and the fans were pretty much okay at best with the films. So this is them rebranding and saying, okay, we get it, now we're listening. More hope, more fun, more excitement. And here's to all that working out. I think everyone wants to see these movies succeed both commercially and critically, so I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Alright guys, with that, I'm going to bring this video to a close. Thank you very much for watching, and as always, if you like what you are seeing, please subscribe, please thumbs up, and please share. One or all of those things are greatly appreciated. For more of my DC movie related videos, you can check out my 5 things that need to happen in order to fix the DCEU, or you can check out my Batman v Superman synopsis. And what do you think about the trailers? Are you excited like me? Do you think that Warner got the message and they're turning everything around? And out of the 3 movies, which one are you most looking forward to? Let's talk about it in the comment section. Until next video, peace.